This whole story started with Ethan taking one big risk.
Most of you guys probably know Leafy is here, a popular YouTuber who's been blowing up big time. I'm actually friends with these guys, so it's awkward and it's uncomfortable. But if for some reason, we as a community have been giving these guys a pass. And I mean, if you look at Leafy's channel, all he does is make fun of kids and like vulnerable people.
We got it all set up here. I'm gonna get out of the bullhorn in a minute and we're gonna see how many takers we have. I'm hoping the prizes will be incentive enough for people to wanna hide the chin.
First story is coming. Ah, all of a sudden I have these sharp pains in my back.
Of course, as time passed, this potential video never saw the light of day. So by sending him this document, I was effectively telling him in private all the things that I wasn't okay with. I will be telling you all of my criticisms of him today, mainly because when you tell him these things privately, he doesn't take action. You have to make this shit public.
Oh man, if only people listened in private conversations. So during my time here, I've had quite a lot of beef with a lot of different YouTubers. And the reasons for that beef kind of range all over the place, like... There's no way that I could explain every single controversy I've ever had. I've definitely gotten into more drama than, I would say, 99% of YouTube, but not 100%, because Keemstar, there's no comparison. Keemstar has, like, battled every single person on this platform, sometimes at the same time, and you know what? If there's one person that is the anime main character of YouTube, dude, I'm absolutely convinced it's Keemstar.
I have debunked all this fucking bullshit, slanderous claims that have been made about me. Whether-
Do I ever think he will overcome the hate? I think everybody has a chance to overcome hate. It just depends on how you present yourself.
Why would I ever want to overcome the hate? Seriously, if I can't fuck with a few people on this goddamn website, then what's the point of any of this?
Do I know how or what the key to that is? My suggestion to him was a while ago. I don't know if he heard me a lot. It was over a year ago. Come out as Calvin, not Leafy is here. I think Calvin's like way more interesting than Leafy.
He doesn't hit me up. Like, I'm trying to hit this kid up. He's not hitting me up at all.
Anyways, though, every now and then I see someone ask, is there any video that someone made on you that really just stands out despite the fact that it's been like 5 years? And the answer to that is always yes. There is one video specifically that I will never understand to this day that definitely lives in my head rent-free.
Meet Leafy is here, a 20-year-old YouTuber that has 4 million subscribers and is a manipulating piece of shit that uses people only to gain more subs and or popularity. Now, I know everybody fucking knows who Leafy is here is, and I guarantee a lot of people think that we're friends. But in this video, I'm gonna show why Leafy is a fucking piece of human trash and why I don't fuck with him anymore. Sorry, Leafy, you had this coming, bro. You shouldn't have fucking used me for 5 months. Anyway, let's get into the video. What the fuck is up, you guys? Nick here, and today I wanna talk about Leafy is here. Now, I'm sure a lot of people weren't expecting this video. And to be honest, this video is very overdue. I should have made this video months ago.
No, not at all, dude. You actually had great timing on this video. Right when there was a big bounty on me, you hit at the perfect time. If I was in your situation at that time period, I'd do the exact same thing. I did the exact same thing to Keemstar, and I would do it again. No one's gonna say this publicly, but we're all looking out for ourselves, and I completely understand why he would make this video. Like, despite all the drama I had with Keemstar, me and Keemstar are friends now, because I respect the grind at the end of the day. I get it.
Because the things I'm about to say in this video, I have been feeling for a very long time. As I said, this video is very overdue. I've known Leafy for about 5 months now, and I feel like the whole time I've known this kid, he's pretty much used me. And in this video, I'm gonna explain why I don't like Leafy and also why he's a piece of shit. I guarantee you're watching this, Leafy, right now, and you're probably shitting your pants. And let me just tell you, don't respond to this video, alright? Like, I'm trying to tell you, don't respond to it.
I wonder what the intentions were with this comment. Like, we all know the reason why he made this video, right? Like, let's be honest for 1 second. Was he, like, trying to piss me off with this comment so I'd, like, make a big response and, you know, he could get a big response after that? Like, I'm assuming it has to be that, because why would he not want me to respond to him? That makes no sense at all. This guy came out 5 years ago saying, you know, he was gonna expose me, you know? We did a few videos together. Of course, the person exposing someone else wants a response from them. Like, come on. Anyways, though, yeah, I never responded to it because it's pretty obvious that's, like, what he wanted. He wanted, like, a big attention thing. It's actually pretty funny. He actually got killed off with the big YouTube demonetization stuff, and that happened only a few weeks after he made this video, which was, like, his big turning point. Unlucky dude.
Now, the first time I talked to Leafy, he had followed me on Twitter, and I think I DM'd him or he DM'd me. And he was like, oh, I love your fucking content, man. It's really fucking good. The first video he ever watched of mine was the Commentary Wars. And he said he loved the video, and then he gave me his Skype. I added him on Skype, and then we talked. And I mean, while we're talking, this kid has, you know, some good shit to say to me. At this point, I'm probably at 20,000, maybe less subscribers. And you got Leafy over here that's sitting at 2 or 3 fucking million subs. Now, for me, this is insane. You know, I'm thinking big opportunities here. Like, holy fuck, this guy likes my content. Maybe he wants to work with me. And in doing so, I can fucking grow. But that's not the case at all. The only thing he needed from me was to use me.
You're telling me that Nicholas Cash, age 30, American YouTuber born from Detroit, got violated by Leafy. Big embarrassing.
PewDiePie had this series called YouTuber High School, and I thought it was funny as fuck. And I seen in the video that, you know, he was using Photoshop, but the way he was recording it, you could still see, like, the square boxes, and you could tell he was in Photoshop. So I took inspiration from that, and I was like, I can do that, but I think I can do it just a tad bit better. So what I did was Photoshop a few things, and I made—
Jesus Christ, what is this explanation? Pretty much he took the video, or he took, like, an image, and he moved it up and down just like this.
Because one day, Leafy had hit me up, and he, you know, he loved the animations that I was doing. And he had asked me to do one for his video.
Yeah, back then I didn't know how to, like, move the image up and down. I'm pretty ass at editing.
So I was fucking geeked up. I'm like, holy shit. Here I am sitting at fucking 15,000 subscribers, and I got a guy with 2 million or 3 million at the time subs, and he wants me to do an intro for him. So I'm immediately geeked up. I ran to my dad, and I'm like, holy fucking shit, like, I'm gonna be a goddamn YouTube star.
Who does he think I am? The fucking Gabby Show? Does he think I'm like Drake and I'm giving him a feature in my song? Dude, I just randomly hit him up and asked him if he wanted to help me out with the video and be a part of the intro. Pretty cringe that he ran to his dad after that, saying he was gonna be the next PewDiePie. Like, despite his appearance, I guess he was a big fangirl. You know, now that I think of it, maybe he wanted me to fucking violate him.
Which is cool, you know? You're a greedy little fucking 20-year-old piece of shit. So I make the first intro for him and I give it to him, and at that point he says, hey man, I'm not gonna give you a shout out, I'm just gonna put you in the description. Because he said, you know, it's just not really shout out worthy, what you did. The few hours, you know, that you took out of your precious time, it's not worth that shout out, you know? You know, I'm gonna put you in the description though, so you could get, you know, 8 or 10 subs, which is really good. No, it fucking wasn't.
Fun fact, I actually did shout this loser out.
So when I hear this, I'm kinda sad. I'm a little depressed. I just took all this time making this fucking intro for this kid, and he's not gonna shout me out. Alright, fine. Whatever. He's gonna put me in the description. Cool. So after I make this intro for him, he doesn't hit me up.
You know, maybe 4 years is all I needed, because 4 years ago, I remember watching this video and thinking, how the fuck does anyone even just follow this? But now that I'm watching it now, it really is starting to make a little bit more sense to me. This guy was a fangirl, and he wanted to be violated. I mean, look at his response to just me not responding to him.
Now remember, there's about 20 people in this group chat, and the kid has not hit me up in about fucking 2 weeks. So after I make the intros, he pays me the 50 bucks, he gives me no shoutouts, he put me in the description. So again, a couple weeks go by and the kid never fucking hits me up. Because the only time this kid hits me up is when he fucking needs something. That's the only time he hits me up. And I don't know why, maybe I was blinded by his subs. I don't know why I was being such a big fat fucking pussy about this whole situation. And I'll admit that, I was being a fucking pussy. Like, I'm trying to hit this kid up. He's not hitting me up at all. I'm like, well, you know, he's a busy guy. He makes fucking daily shitty videos that are super unfucking funny. You know, maybe he's just, you know, taking time to make his shit videos. But no, what I'm guessing is he had used me for what he needed, and then, you know, he moved up. He's not hitting me up at all. I'm like, well, so I'm like, fuck this guy. Fuck this fucking piece of shit. I'm making a fucking video on this kid. Like, I'm gonna go in on this guy.
Was I drunk and I fucked this retard and I forgot about it or something? What is this?
I'm like, well, I'm trying to hit this kid up. He's not hitting me up at all.
Dude is acting like a crazy ex-girlfriend, and to be fair, I think I am too. Randomly, 4 years down the line, I decided to make an entire video about this. But I'll admit, dude, this video has lived in my head just rent-free for the longest time. Yeah, he's a clingy pussy, but I will admit, someone definitely could say I'm a little bit psychotic and I need to get a life.
Because he's a piece of fucking shit. He's a greedy little motherfucker that just wants to use people and gain. And gain from them. Open it up, Pandora's box. I don't give a fuck anymore. So I want to make sure I mention that. Leafy fucking hates Pyrocynical. He thinks he's copied his whole style, and he just does not like him at all. Just want to...
I mean, he did.
Like, people call me a Leafy clone that, but it was legit the case. It's-
like, that video is pretty much mine. But of course, Leafy had to put his spin on it, say literally 1,000 fucking times, and repeat himself over and over again. Made stupid points because he really didn't have any points, because this whole move... was a business decision. Well, Leafy, I guess this is my business decision with you.
Well, look at that, dude. I think I educated my fangirl and taught her how YouTube works, and obviously this video is a result of that. I guess I'm not that bad after all, dude. I taught her how to YouTube. Oh, wait, never mind. Literally unlucky, or... I think I can do it once. Dude, oh my god, literally unlucky!
So we're sitting there talking, and I'm pretty much about to get to the breaking point of why I'm making this video. It's really everything that just boiled up. So he tells me, dude, you should make a video on H3H3. He's like, I wish I could be in your shoes, you know? With your amount of subscribers, you can make any video you want. And all you need to worry about right now is attention. So dude, you should make a video on H3H3. The reason he wants me to make a video on H3H3 is because Leafy fucking hates this guy.
And them shoes.
And I'm in a Skype group chat that contains like 20 people. And a lot of those people are pretty big YouTubers. And other, you know, just cool-ass fuckers. And I'm telling them, you know, Leafy, just use me.
Dude, is he like a victim of like a sex ring or some shit? Yeah, use the shit out of you, dude, because you're a fucking idiot and you got a nice ass. I'm sorry if you had feelings for me, dude.
And a lot of people were pissed off and saying, why are you copying Leafy? Oh my god, this guy's a Leafy wannabe. Look, he's doing the intros like Leafy does.
You know, those comments are giving him a lot of justice. This is not a B-list Leafy. This is not a Leafy clone. This is definitely just a Leafy fangirl.
And them shoes.
Now, I know a lot of people are thinking, you know, hey, what the fuck? It's 20 bucks. I mean, he ended up paying me 50 bucks, but that's not fucking shit.
Then why did you accept it? What are you, a 13-year-old girl? You don't know how to say no? Like, let me get this straight. I offered you $20. I ended up paying you 250% commission. In what world, culture, or society would anyone get paid 250% of what they agreed to do and then have another issue on top of that? If you had an issue with a normal commission, then you shouldn't have done it. This is so pathetic, man. Even if, hypothetically, every single thing he said in this video was absolutely true, it still wouldn't even work on its own narrative. Man, dude, it makes no sense. Despite all the time, I just cannot get over this video. Dude, it is so fucking crazy on so many levels. I don't care about the backstabbing. I don't care that he roasted me. I don't care that he decided to make a video on me or that he lied. It's just the logic makes no sense to me. I'm not even joking about this. When I saw this video, I was convinced that every single person in this, you know, so-called community was just 10 years old. Like, I was convinced that for at least, like, 6 months. Like, I remember just randomly seeing, like, a comment being like, how could you only pay him $20? That's so low. You have a lot of money. Yeah, it doesn't matter how much money you have. The whole point of negotiating with someone is to try to get the best price possible for the work or service that you're getting. It doesn't matter how much money is at stake. It doesn't matter what time period you're in. If you're trading a fucking rock for a carrot, you should be trying to get as many carrots as you possibly can for that rock. Like, you're telling me that if Jim's offering you 30 carrots for a rock and Joe is offering you 1 carrot for a rock, you wouldn't go with Jim? Okay, this video just rubs me the wrong way and it pisses me off, and I think I got it all out, guys. I feel so much better now. He ended up removing the video a few years later. I think maybe he realized, maybe on his 30th birthday, that if you don't want to do something, consider saying no.
How much are you gonna pay me, dude? Is 20 bucks okay? Alright, sure, yeah, I mean, fuck, if you're gonna pay me, that's what's up.
To wrap up this video, after I recorded the last part, it still just didn't sit with me because of how absolutely batshit that video was. I couldn't get over it. Like, I thought it was only 4 years. It's actually 5 years old, and man, it's still, I still can't get over it, man. So I ended up calling PayPal. I sat on the phone for 3 hours, and I actually found a resolution, and I think I finally have moved on from this, and it's not going to be renting headspace anymore. So essentially, on the phone, after I got connected to a representative, I was actually able to charge back the amount of money I sent to him. Now, quick little note, I could have charged back all of the money, but obviously, man, I'm not gonna do that. Like, what do you think I am? I'm only gonna be charging back the $30, he can keep the $20. We agreed on the 15-second intro where he moves around the image for a bit for the $20, so he can keep the $20. But that bonus $30, yeah, I think I'm gonna take that back, and, you know, I think I'm gonna get some Taco Bell right now.
You gotta make some money! And I understand, you know, he only had, like, I believe at this time, $700,000 in the bank, and that's not that much. He was barely scrapping by, you know? I had, like, about $5 in my PayPal, so...
Make that negative 25. Unlucky, GG, well played.
Long cane, big kind, sniff the line for the fifth time. I've never been to Kettering, but I swear I get it in this time. Me like, oh, I can't believe this swine, international clown, frightened the kid.
You are a vile slime of a human that will, nobody will ever want you because you're so pathetic.